If you are a returning subbie or viewer of mine, you're probably looking at the title of this video and you're going,
didn't she just publish a video recently about how to pay off a mortgage early?
I did, but I never said in that video that paying off a mortgage early was the best idea. And I know it seems counterintuitive to, on one hand, show you how to pay off a mortgage early, and on the other hand, tell you why you shouldn't. But this is YouTube land, where everything makes sense and nothing makes sense all at the same time. If you're a returning subbie, hey boo, and if you're new here, subscribe to join the tea party. Okay, so there are three reasons why I think paying off a mortgage could be a bad idea, especially in 2021. And one benefit to not paying it off early, which I will explain at the end of this video. So roll with me as I spill the tea on this exciting topic. So number one, when you're focused on paying off your mortgage early, meaning you're either paying extra money on your mortgage every month, on interest, or on your principal, you're actually taking money away from any rainy day savings that you can acquire at this time. That extra money that you can be adding to your emergency fund. If this pandemic has taught us anything, it's that you can definitely expect the unexpected when it comes to life in general. You go to sleep one night peacefully in your PJs, tucked away in your cozy bed, and you wake up the next morning and your house is on fire. It happens, unfortunately. So saving for a rainy day is so important when it comes to personal finance. You should have at least 3 months saved in your emergency fund, but if you're putting all of your extra cash towards your mortgage, that can take away from that. Also, you want to diversify your assets, even if you have debt like a mortgage, because investments help to build security for your future. And like I mentioned before, if all of your extra money is going towards your mortgage, that can take away from future planning, and you're losing the chance to earn higher returns and benefit from compound growth by investing in the stock market. It's reasonable to expect a 7% to 8% return if you invest in the broader market. Meanwhile, your mortgage is probably below 4.5% and may be much lower, so at most, you're likely getting a 4.5% return on any money that you're putting towards your mortgage. You're better off doing something with the money that'll earn you close to double the return you get from paying off your mortgage loan ahead of schedule. The second reason why you should not pay your mortgage off early is that you'll miss out on tax breaks. If you itemize your taxes by taking specific deductions as opposed to claiming the standard deductions, you can actually deduct interest paid on your mortgage. When you deduct your mortgage, this reduces your taxable income for the year, meaning you may pay less percent of your income in taxes if you fall into a lower tax bracket. Plus, if you're using your extra money to pay on your mortgage that could otherwise have gone into like a 401k or an IRA, you're also giving up a tax break each year that you could have gotten for retirement savings. And you don't have to itemize to claim these tax breaks for retirement investments, which means you can claim them even if you take the standard deduction. The third reason why you should not be paying off your mortgage early is that inflation offsets savings and interest. So there's this common belief that it's better to get the guaranteed return that comes from mortgage repayment, since there's no guarantee that the invested money will actually grow. The problem is you need to factor in inflation when deciding if this strategy makes sense. Due to inflation, your mortgage actually becomes cheaper to pay over time, since the value of your money erodes, but the mortgage payment stays the same, assuming that you have a fixed rate loan. So for instance, if you have a monthly payment of $1,500 today, in 25 years, that $1,500 that you'll pay towards your mortgage will be the equivalent of around $942 of today's dollars, of that, you know, in the future, assuming inflation of 2% annually. Since your mortgage payment is continually getting cheaper over time, it seldom makes sense to repay it faster. Don't forget that all the interest savings you net from paying off the mortgage early are also reduced by inflation, making this even less of a good deal over time. And now for the benefit of not paying off your mortgage early, and it could actually make you money. If you've read the book, A Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, and I'll leave a link to it in the description, you've heard the theory of good debt versus bad debt. And regardless of your opinion about his philosophies about money, the man is right when it comes to debt. Many investors use debt to flip homes and increase their cash flow. If you are in a home now that you've purchased but you don't see yourself living there forever, why waste your cash trying to pay it off early when you could either sell it for more than the loan is worth, as long as the value of it is worth more than you purchased the loan for through your renovations or maybe just changes in the market, right? Or number two, rent it out for more than your monthly mortgage cost, which will eventually pay off your mortgage without you having to dip into your own wallet. Now, here is a major disclaimer. This piece of advice may not bode well in 2021 because the real estate market is just crazy right now. And it's very unpredictable what could happen, right? And if you sell or rent out your home, you may be hard pressed to find a replacement home to stay in because houses nowadays are going like crazy off the market. I mean, it's like a war zone out here. So it may be hard for you to find a replacement shelter or place to stay if you choose to sell your home. It may not be as easy for you to find a replacement, is all I'm saying. It might be easy for you to sell it, but it may not be easy for you to purchase another home, okay? So just keep that in mind if you're you're watching this in 2021, which you probably are because it's 2021 right now, but you know, the future of the internet is eternal, so. A lot of real estate agents are recommending people to stay put until the market settles down some. And by the way, I am not a real estate agent. I am just your regular, degular, everyday woman. I am not a real estate agent. So please do not quote me on this advice. I've done the research and I'm just giving you the research that I've found. But in theory, having a home as a source of an investment by using good debt, as Robert Kiyosaki would say, is usually a good idea. It usually works well. But remember, we're living in an upside down world where everything is the same but different at the same time. It's 2021, guys. So if you got some value from this video, throw me a like. And if you want more content like this about personal finance and building generational wealth for you and your family, subscribe. Hit that bell to be notified when I drop my newest video. Help your girl out. Until next time, friends. Bye.